Branched chain amino acids. You've seen them everywhere from supplements to energy drinks, but what are they and do they actually do anything? In this video, I'm gonna tell you what this well-known supplement can and can't do. How's it going, guys? My name's Richie Kerwin and I'm a nutritionist and nutrition researcher at Liverpool John Moores University. And you're watching the My Protein YouTube channel. This is the channel that brings you need to know info on how to fuel your body and train to be your strongest self. BCAAs are probably one of the most common supplements sold on the market today. Some people swear by them, some people think they're garbage. But what does the science actually say? Today, we'll talk about BCAAs, what they are, how do you get them, how do they work, and are they even necessary and should you be adding them to your shopping cart? We'll also talk about a use for BCAAs that you might not have thought of before. Everyone knows that protein is made from amino acids, right? Of the 20 amino acids, 9 are essential, meaning we can't make them from other amino acids in our bodies and we have to get them from our diet. Of those, 3 are called branched chain amino acids because of their branched carbon structure. Those amino acids are valine, isoleucine, and the most well-known, leucine. And they have very important roles to play in protein metabolism, neural function, and insulin regulation. Most people know that protein is essential for building muscle, but people don't actually know why. Think of your body as a building that has 2 processes going on at the same time, building up and tearing down. If you want to maintain the building, you need to keep the 2 processes in balance. If you don't do as much building up compared to tearing down, the building gets smaller. Think of your muscles shrinking. On the other hand, if you do more building up than normal, the building, or your muscles, gets bigger over time. This building up process is called muscle protein synthesis, and the tearing down process is called muscle protein breakdown. Both happen all the time in our bodies, but there are a couple of things that we can do to stimulate muscle protein synthesis. The first is exercise, especially resistance exercise. This is the most important signal for starting muscle protein synthesis. Think of it as opening the gates of a construction site. Without the signal from exercise, muscle growth doesn't really happen. The other way we can increase MPS is by eating protein, specifically the BCAA leucine, which is a key trigger for starting the muscle building process. Think of leucine as the foreman that calls all the other amino acids to the construction yard. Remember this example of the foreman for a little later. This is why foods like whey protein that are high in BCAAs, and especially leucine, are really useful for stimulating muscle growth, especially after exercise. If a protein has a lot of leucine, it'll probably stimulate MPS really well. And in research, studies often match the leucine content of proteins to compare different protein sources. Here's the thing. While BCAAs help to signal the start of MPS, you still need all the other essential amino acids to keep the muscle building process going. Think of the foreman we mentioned earlier. On a building site without any bricks, not a lot of building is going to get done. Those bricks are the other essential amino acids you need to build muscle. That's why if building muscle is your goal, you should really make sure you're getting a lot of high quality protein when you need it. So if you eat plenty of meat, fish, eggs, dairy products like whey, you probably don't need any BCAAs at all. By plenty, I mean around 1.6 grams per kilogram of body weight per day or more. So for a 70 kilogram person, that works out at least 112 grams of protein a day. That should be spread pretty evenly between meals. So if you have 4 meals a day, that's 28 grams of protein minimum at each meal. So why would anyone need BCAAs at all? Well, if someone has a hard time getting enough total protein in their diet, or specifically in each meal, adding some BCAAs could help to stimulate MPS. But you could argue, if you could get some BCAAs, you should be able to get some whey protein. And the truth is, that would probably be a lot better. Another time when BCAAs may be useful is if the protein you eat is lower quality. And by that, I mean lower in BCAAs or leucine, like some vegan diets, for example. So for example, if you eat plant-based protein sources like beans, quinoa, soy, these are lower in the BCAA leucine and might not stimulate muscle growth as well as the same amount of animal protein. Adding some BCAAs, like 3 grams of leucine, could help stimulate muscle growth better. Eating more protein, even if it's slightly lower quality, could also help. Finally, here's a use for BCAAs that you might not have thought of. Endurance training. Yep, a concept most gym goers are terrified of. Anything to do with cardio. Adding BCAAs to your carbohydrate drink during and after endurance events, like marathons, might actually reduce muscle damage and feelings of muscle soreness. Although it's probably not going to improve endurance performance. So if you do a lot of endurance training and want to feel more recovered after your sessions, taking a carbohydrate drink with added BCAAs could be a good option. So remember, BCAAs have a definite function in your diet, but BCAA supplements are just a way of supplementing a diet that's either too low in protein or has a low protein quality. Your best option would be to try and increase the amount of protein you eat. Whey is a great supplement to improve that. Or try and improve the quality of the proteins you eat on a vegan diet by using soy or rice or pea protein blend, or just eat more of them. That said, branched chain amino acids can help give plant-based proteins that little kick that they might need for optimal muscle protein synthesis if you can't or don't want to eat more protein. So, did that answer your questions? As always, if you have any more, let me know in the comments below, and remember to like and subscribe to the MyProtein YouTube channel for more great evidence-based information.